Okay, let's take a quick look at Bank Nifty and see what is Bank Nifty doing. Bank Nifty, on the weekly chart, there is no change. It just came down a little bit more today. Inside yesterday's price action itself. Now, the best part about Bank Nifty is that, now it's a very crucial point for Bank Nifty. Okay, this supply is holding right now. But once we go above that, I expect Bank Nifty as a precursor may at least go to 38,000, anywhere between 38,000 to 39,000, or maybe even try to retest this supply. So Bank Nifty is showing a good price action. And if you take, if you took a look at individual stocks in the banking sector, so let's go quickly to Bank Nifty stocks and see. Other than this guy and probably this guy, both results done, or trending stocks, he's a big boss. So this is the logic now, Avneet. This is the logic. So you saw that there are these two guys who have come down, but Bank Nifty is holding its demand zone. And we have an event which is going to affect the banking sector. Yes? You just need to look at which of these stocks the other. So there are two aspects to this. The other stocks, have they come into good controlling demand zone? So like SBI, and I missed it today because it just flew. Okay, take a look at it. Maybe IndusInd Bank is coming, but IndusInd Bank has results somewhere. So take a look at stocks which are done with their results, hit their controlling demand zones and trying to move. And with stocks like HDFC and ICICI Bank, if you see where they are, you won't mind buying it for the event. Okay, so we'll take a look at that. We'll come to a look at those. So on the daily, that's the picture we have, but now Bank Nifty is more on the smaller time frame. Now understand one thing. If you see Bank Nifty, remember our levels on Tuesday. We'll take a look, Peter. Hold on. This is what RVS mentioned. Do you see that demand zone? Do we have an achievement by that demand zone? Yeah, first time it's holding that demand zone. That's the area of demand zone. It's nicely coming in a compressive fashion, actually, Bank Nifty on a 25 minute chart. On a 15 minute chart, again, there is no supply demand that has been breached here, except for this area, but we are having rejections also. Let's see on a smaller time frame what is Bank Nifty doing. Okay. That's your place to show your himmat. Clear, everyone? Yeah. Worth it. So that's 937,000 and 250 odd points. 36,800 here. Okay, Vinit. I mean, it is closer to that. 36,800 is somewhere close to this point. Yeah, so they extend that in that 5 minute demand zone, right? Yeah, so that's where, take it, okay? Take it. So those who want to, so this is, let's say we are going to look at it as a 300 point risk minimum. So if you take only one lot, you're going to have about 6,000 or 7,000 risk. And if it is more than your risk, then you take an entry that is deeper, which will reduce your risk. And if you miss it, then look at a 15-minute confirmation and then go long. Nifty gave a new low, right, Jignesh? Look at Bank Nifty. Now you see where my focus is. इस पे पैसा लगाया था बुकी पे. हमारा ऋषभ पंत है वो.
Hi guys, I am Vaneet, one of the students, new students I would say, with Ajit, and I've done a few mentoring sessions with him, and the way he explains the trade, it's totally amazing. And last session which we had, which the Bank Nifty made a bottom and he told us to get in the trade, and after that Bank Nifty had gained 900 points the next 1 hour. It was so incredible to see Nifty and Bank Nifty behave like the way he wanted, like the way he said. And it was the Nifty and Bank Nifty both are behaving same way. He explained the chart, why we took the trade, why we are at the bottom of the demand zone and we took the trade. It was totally amazing to see his work. And bas I will continue with him for a long time, because I am not a professional trader, but the way he explains the trade is just simply amazing. It's so simple, and I just want to follow him however he does. Thank you.